Hi everyone. I thought I would do a quick review for my V12. I'm pretty sure I have somewhere pretty close to 400 miles on it. I've had it since for about 2 weeks now. I just got back from the Seattle ride yesterday. I went up there with some of the Portland crew. One thing I do want to say is that Tyler up there had the updated software on his V12, and it felt surprisingly better than my V12 without the most current software update. They definitely improved the slow stopping, and it feels much more nimble. Right now, my complaint about the V12 is that it's not as nimble on the trails. And a lot of that has to do with this being my first 100-volt wheel. It's significantly heavier than the 16X, and I'm still learning to throw my weight around on it. Right now I have my pedals at the lowest setting. I definitely need to get some pedal plates. I was supposed to pick some up from Merlin Fish yesterday, but I missed linking up with him. Sometimes that happens on the rides, but I'm excited to get some studded pedals. I have been using these version 3 Clark pads, and at first I thought they weren't aggressive enough for me, but after I cut them, honestly I wish I didn't cut them like in the zigzag position. I just wish I would have like cut it straight, because I find that these like cross sections get in the way of how I want to angle the pads. In my opinion, the pads are a little too long, and I want to narrow them down, so I had to trim a little bit of the padding to force it to fit. I don't know if you guys can see it there, but right here you can kind of see, like, oh, I trimmed it a little bit, trying to like make it more aggressive of a tilt, and I might even build it up with some power pads or some you know, just little padding like I did down here, like I did on Lolixina showed me, you know, how it's important to put a little bit of padding out here on the wheels that have a curvature where your foot wants to like flip in. A few things I love about the V12 are the bleeps and the bloops. It's definitely the iPhone of the current wheels. And I have seen more experienced riders than me ride this V12, Cameron, Massey, and Tyler Stites. Those guys like rip around on this wheel easily going like over 40 miles an hour. For me, I'm still getting comfortable escaping out of the 84-volt wheel. I definitely went over 31 miles an hour yesterday on the Seattle ride. But as embarrassing as it is to say, I haven't changed my kilometers per hour to miles per hour yet, because I don't have the software update, and I actually don't know the conversion. And when I'm ripping and running really fast, I'm more focused on my line than what my wheel is reading out. And in motion is gonna like let me know if I'm going too fast, and I'm not even touching that edge yet. So don't ask me how it is, like, oh, reaching the edge of this wheel, because I don't have the skill to get there yet safely. One of the things I don't like about this wheel, especially for doing Uber Eats, which is what I'm getting ready to do right now, is the handle release. It's this really weird thing where there's two buttons under here. There's one really far up front that's just like a little button, and then there's a big middle button right here, which is the kill switch. And then back here, there is about 25% room underneath this handle to maybe put a seat on there. And I did watch Marty's seat video, and I am planning to try to add a suspension seat onto here. I just need to buy all the stuff off of Amazon and give it a go. But the thing I don't like about this handle release is that you have to click this button way up front, and then you have to lift from the back of the handle to open the handle. So if I have something in my hand, like food, and I go to like put my wheel down, it's like, oh man, it's like kind of you need two hands. So it is definitely, it's not as intuitive as the kingsong handle. That thing was just oh so great for doing deliveries. Like the click release pull up thing was just so amazing, and I'm a little disappointed to see this in motion handle be so complicated, but I bet you if I get it just right, like, you know, once I get 500 more miles on it, I'll probably be able to like do the one-handed thing. But when I'm carrying like a bunch of stuff and trying to balance food, it's just one more thing I have to worry about. I love the kickstand. The kickstand's really cool. It's like, oh, you just pop that thing down, kill switch, and it goes down. The color schemes are really nice. I accidentally downloaded my friend's color scheme, another gift from Cameron Massey, the pink and the blue color scheme. And again, we're still waiting for the software update. Some of the people have gotten it and some of the people have not, and I'm not sure what the holdup is, but I'm grateful to be on a batch one wheel. And sometimes with batch one wheels, you have to give and take a little bit and not complain too much about having the latest and greatest wheel. So anyways, that is about it. I love the smoothness. It is very similar to the 16X, a little heavier, definitely more punchy. The smoothest ride I've had in a 16-inch tire. I mean, it's uncomparable to the 16X. And honestly, when I got on that V12 yesterday that had the software update, it was a pretty big jump in smoothness and nimbleness again. So I'm really excited to get the software update. I'm hoping to get that sometime soon. I'll follow up with eWheels. I know that they're out there doing their best trying to get us all of our wheels on time with all of the shipping delays and the battery delays and all the stuff going on. So I am grateful. And I haven't had any issues with my wheel at all. It's been great. So anyways, I just wanted you guys to see the V12. Have me give a little rundown of my initial thoughts after about 400 miles here. Maybe once I get that software update, I'll do another little review video. But thanks for watching. I'll see you guys out.